Hello, this is Mr. Chabry. We're here with some more Omega Ruby Wanderlock. Last time we reached Lily Cove City, and I wanted to show off this Pokemon right here. We finally went ahead and evolved Graveler. So now we've got a Golem, a beautiful Golem. Don't have the bottom screen, but pretend you saw a nice, beautiful Golem. Anyway, go ahead and heal up first. I forgot to do that last time. So we're going to go ahead heal up our Pokemon, and you can see the Golem right there. We're going to get some use out of this Golem. Hopefully it'll stick around for a while. Golem's not really a Pokemon you use. I've used that often. It's got really bad special defense, so that's usually a thing that holds it back. But I think that decent attack, decent defense would be pretty nice. Anyway. Now we've already got some of our encounters already. What would be a good idea to switch into things that could actually help us in a battle? So let's go ahead and put this guy up. I need a good electric type. I think Luxray so far is my only option in that regard. I do have this thing now. It would be nice to use this thing, but that's a lot of leveling up, and I think I'm fine with Lux right now. I think I'm fine with Luxray. I really want to get Floette leveled up. This thing is a really, really good Pokemon as a Florges, and I think it would be nice to, you know, use it. Go ahead and run out here. We're going to see if we can finish up the Team Magma hideout stuff in this one episode. So let's go ahead and head to the beach. The beach is where you want to go. Might have to go up this way. Of course, we have to do all this to get up there. Come on. Up. There we go. This town's not very well put together. Anyway, we can't go across the sea yet. So I think up here is actually the hideout. Yeah, up here. It's not a really good hideout if it's in clear view of one of the largest cities in Hoenn. But I guess it's not a good hideout. You just go into this cave and there's like the Team Magma symbol and right there in clear view. Not really a hideout, it's more of just a base of operations. But here you can see they've got some magma, they're doing something with it. If you're playing Pokemon Sapphire, I'm sure it's water flowing through the tubes. Anyway, we're going to have a lot of battles here, I would say. And I think it's a good time as any. Try to get Floette leveled up. I think that's what I want to do. Alright, so I honestly don't remember my path around here. So we're gonna try to get as much, I guess, levels as we can onto Floette. Got a nugget, that's good. I don't think that person battles. I think that person just goes on to a monologue about how the magma goes through it or something. Yeah. Like, hot. Magma in this tube is hot. Well, yeah. Wonder in Alpha Sapphire what they say. Maybe the water's still hot in the Alpha Sapphire. Alright, so here in this like little lobby area, we gotta battle this lady. Alright, so she's got a Nimmel. If we had some water type moves for Floette, I don't think it can learn any. But if we did, I would feel comfortable with this matchup. As it stands, I don't feel comfortable. Let's go into Gabite. Swanna is like overleveled. Honestly, Gabite is overleveled, but not as much as Swanna, so I'd rather go into Gabite to get some experience too. We're going to get burnt, which is annoying. It's going to make it a little bit tougher for us to one-shot things. Dragon Claw. Go for a Dragon Claw. Like it's going to be a two-hit KO. Takedown's going to do more back to the Numel. Because Numel's not really a good physical attacker. But anyway, one more Dragon Claw will do the trick. And then we just go back and Floette, get some experience. Alright, let's go ahead. Go into Floette. We got our coughing here. Not much I can do about coughing. We have to go Floette and then probably Swanna. Actually, no. The reason why I'm saying no to Swanna is because this thing could have Explosion. I've got one Pokemon that can actually come in and handle Explosion pretty well. Let's get some use out of Golem here. Or Sludge Bomb. Oh yeah, Golem's taking that. And we can easily go for it. We'll see a Stone Edge. Stone Edge should one-shot, I think, maybe. Oh yeah. Golem is a wonderful Pokemon. Level 27 on the Floette, wants to learn grassy terrain. Not really worried about grassy terrain. The only thing it could really, you know, I can see that helping is Sceptile. But that's it. Let's go ahead and heal up. I did not bring any form of healing item. Okay, let's just use a berry that we have. Which one is it for burn? I don't think I got it. It's the raspberry. I don't have it though. Hold on. Give some citrus to the good bite. Just in case I need it to come out. But the fact that it's burnt, I probably won't be using it. Oh, you heal up here or something? Can you heal up here? I just wasted two berries. At least it was two berries and not, you know. Anyway, we can heal up in this little bed area. This is where Team Magma sleeps, I guess. Do you battle? Oh, yeah. I just interrupted this guy's programming. But anyway. Coughing. I'm going straight into Golem for this thing. There's no reason to stay in and let Floette take a nasty Sludge Bomb. There's no reason for that. Alright, Golem. Are we going to see a Haze? I can actually Smackdown and then Earthquake. What do I want to do? Smackdown, then Earthquake. Okay, it's going to self-destruct. That's not going to do anything to Golem. Golem's got such good bulk. That was nice. Alright, Numel comes out. Numel, we just go with Floette and then Gabite again, I think. I think that's the plan. Yeah, let's go ahead and get Gabite out here. Gabite needs some experience because it evolves way later on in the game. So hopefully we can get that going. Because once we get a Garchomp, we're going to be in a really good position. Garchomp's like one of the best dragon types around at all. Like, you know, pretty much out of all the dragon types, Garchomp's up there at the top. Another curse. That curse actually helped it survive, but yeah, it's not going to live another one of these. Alright. And I wonder how much experience Floette's going to get. Get another level on Floette. Alright, so go ahead and try to get as far as we can. There's an item back here. The person's just staring at the vending machine. Actually, let's grab some pop. keep getting some soda pop. You can get some lemonade too. I think Moo Moo Milk is like the best item though. In terms of like, you know, beverage item that heals up your Pokemon. Alright. I think we're good. Go ahead and just walk up to this person. Alright, and we got a Mightyena, so if we had like a good fairy move on Floette, I think we would be fine here. But, I mean, we've only got Fairy Wind, and that's not really that great. I think I want to get Ninja out here. We'll get Ninja out here, maybe Mega Evolve just for extra, you know, extra damage output. And then, you know, hit this thing as hard as we can. We need something like Giga Drain. I'm surprised we haven't learned that yet. We still have Mega Drain. If we get Giga Drain, it's going to be a lot better. We get Leaf Storm. It's going to be a lot better. So he's going to waste time taunting and then embargoing. Alright, Leaf Blade. Boom, boom, bop. And it's gone. Easy. Pretty easy. Nothing too hard. Alright, level 28. Still no good fairy type move. Don't remember the correct path. It's not there. Not the chair. Go ahead and jump up here. And this lead us. This little area. Oh, here we go. Dark Pulse. Now, Dark Pulse is a really good move. Honestly, don't think I've got anything to teach it to, though. I don't think Floette learns it. I mean, I could try it out, but I don't think Floette learns Dark Pulse. So, we'll just try to continue this way. That's a meteorite, isn't it? Maybe we have to fight this guy. Oh. That's the meteor. Basically, the meteor isn't a part of the plan anymore, I guess. Originally, they were going to use the meteor to make to make their own red orb, but it didn't work out. Here we have the magma suit. Right, if not for Tabitha, aka Tabby Tabby, they've got like a pet name for Tabitha? Why? Proper way. Is this the correct way? Why do they got so many orc tiles? That might come in handy soon. The PowerPoint Max. I don't think you go in this door. Alright, it's just a note saying dangerous inside. This whole place should be considered dangerous. It's like magma flowing through different areas. But anyway, no idea the layout of this. You can sleep here, can't you? Why is there some beds that you can sleep at and some that don't? I don't get that. It makes sense if, you know, you can either sleep in all of them or none of them. Anyway, I think the actual path that we want to take is up this way. Now, I want to throw all that just to get caught running down the corridor. I was like, wait a second, I just heard something. Oh, there it is. Alright, we got a Golbat here. Alright, so... Golbat... Luxray is the answer. Luxray's kind of falling behind, and I don't want it to fall behind. So we'll go into Luxray here. Get Intimidate. I mean, luckily we were able to switch out before that mean look trapped our Floette in. Floette's not doing anything against the Golbat. Not at all. Not in the slightest. Alright, level 40. Well, that's level 29. I think we evolve Floette. Not through a stone, is it? Either like in like 30s or stone. Not totally sure. Is this the correct path? I think this is the correct path because I remember there's like a little puzzle where you have to do these little shenanigans. Don't remember the proper order. Take us back. Oh, it takes us back. Oh. This way then? Yeah, and then maybe you skip that one, go to that one. Here we go. Wait. This is team. This is Maxie's hideout. Got an Electrode here. That we have to contend with. Actually, we could just run from Electrode. He's not gonna let us run. Well. No, I should have looked. See if this is its own area. Well, it doesn't matter. It's going to self-destruct anyway. So even if it's in its own area, I would lose the encounter here. So we get free experience. Luckily, that wasn't on Floette. Floette would not be able to handle that. Yes, that would have counted as its own area. Team Magma hideout. Darn. We could have had an encounter here. I mean, not much you can do because, you know, the Electrodes like to go kaboom. Not much you can do about that. I do not like this puzzle at all. I guess you go this way. Skippy? No. Is there nothing else for us in that little area? Maybe that's it? All you get, maybe? Just the Master Ball? Yeah. Here's where we're supposed to be. We're supposed to be in this area. We just took a detour to grab the Master Ball. Which is not going to be helpful right now. There's a certain encounter we'll have that I need to use the Master Ball for. The Pokemon in question, I can't use it on the team because, you know, you have to wander trade it and everything. But it would be cool to catch it and then, you know, put it on the trading block. Anyway, let's get Golem out here. I want to see a takedown. Golem laughs. Takedown. Takedown does nothing to Golem. Golem is like so defensively bulky. Alright, and we take that out pretty easily. Golem, level 41. Well, that's level 30. Alright, nice. Alright, so here is the Horde battle. I would like to lead Floette to get that experience. And do that. I might turn this on just for this battle. Just so Floette can get some residual experience. And it looks like we're going to have a horde battle. That's why I wanted Golem up front, because Golem has Earthquake. Earthquake is such a good move. It's hits everyone. We're going to see a horde of Poochyena. I'm not worried about Poochyena. We face so many Poochyenas. This does not scare me. And the game takes a while to decide what's happening. Nice. Quick and easy. Horde Battles wasn't around very long. It's just a Generation 6 thing, and that's it. Alright, before we continue, let's turn this off before I forget about it. And we'll go ahead and put Floette back up front, because I need experience on that thing. Need experience for Floette. Looks like we'll have to face Courtney once again. I knew you would come. Oh, you can't walk past Courtney yet. The Marine has been upgraded. Look at that drill. There's still more work for me to do. I must stop you until Maxi Leader departs. Want to analyze. Why does she talk like that? I don't think she talks like that in Ruby. It's just a Omega Ruby thing. Tries to pretend that she's robotic or something. I don't know. It's what she does. Alright, let's go into Swanna. At this rate, Swanna's... All the opponent's Pokemon are catching up to Swanna. That's going to make it tougher to, you know, level up the other Pokemon. We're going to be put to sleep. I've got a Chesto if I need it. We're just going to Surf, try to get rid of this thing this turn right now. Before we fall asleep. And a Surf should do the job. Alright, nice. Quick and easy. Camera Up does not stand a chance. Well, it's level 31. Nice. Alright, change the world. He just stopped us from stopping the submarine. Alright. So, now I think we have to go to Moss Deep. Is that the place? Moss Deep, the little island city. Anyway, we're back here now. We just exit pretty quickly. I mean, this is a pretty cool little area. I like how when you walk up there, it's like the camera goes up and you see this whole thing. Pretty neat. Here we go, Lilico City. And we do get some encounters soon. So... what I'm going to do is actually go back to the Pokemon Center. Make sure I have Pokemon that's not going to one-shot everyone. Because we get a lot of encounters now. But anyway, we're going to actually end the episode here. We did quite a bit of stuff. If you like this, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe. I will see you in the next Pokemon video.